my artistic practice has developed through the years, I think. And basically, it's connected to curiosity, I think. I always wanted to somehow understand better different kinds of music, and I started really young as a solo boy soprano performer and I thought when my voice broke that it would be interesting to gradually learn more about how the voice works. And because as a boy singer, it's natural, it's sort of, it's there. And but later in life, you need to find out about things, and you need to develop and somehow find your own voice in a way. And so I tried different things, and then later I got really interested in theater and also the space we use to do something with music. And at the same time, I wanted to find a way that would give music sort of the lead, that the music was telling the story somehow along with other means. So like when you're on stage, it's almost two-dimensional. But if you somehow involve the space in another way, and I'm not talking about a lot of things, it can be something really, really simple, it sort of can change the emotion and also how people receive what is happening in a different way, in a somehow three-dimensional way, I think. It has developed into being more connected to maybe different art forms. But the music somehow may be the most important factor. And then finding, let's say, other practices in art that can in some way support the music. So what I'm always interested in is to find the core, the root of what I would like to do. And often it's sort of not clear when you start working, and I think that's important, to allow it to develop, so to allow it to be unclear and then gradually listen. It's so important to listen where this project wants to go without losing completely control, but allowing for mistakes on the way, and then it gradually builds up and it becomes more clear, and also these elements that then come into the picture, they reveal themselves. You could maybe say that they suddenly jump onto the stage and they need to be there to give this what I call three-dimensional experience for both the performer and the audience. And I think this maybe defines my approach to using other means through different art practices. The way I usually work, let's say there is an idea I would like to pursue and find a way to work with, and then usually I start to think what kind of people or artists would be the right people for this kind of project. And this can be other musicians or singers or people from the world of theater. I mean, video art is so important today because that's how people look at the world somehow. It's through the lens, and it's important to have somebody who can help you with those things, because I don't do that myself, and I try to involve somebody who sort of takes part in the project, not necessarily from the beginning, but comes into the project maybe gradually, and then to involve the other artists in some way, trying to bring out the best from each and every one. And this can take a long time, and I find with myself that I need to be prepared to wait, to allow the project to take a long time. And by doing so, I need to call on my patience. And I think I had much more patience when I was younger. And I even developed a special way of calling on my patience. So this energy to just jump at the project and do it quickly, it's important to stop and think and allow more things to come into whatever I'm working on, and then it becomes more enjoyable because it builds up layer upon layer, and usually it becomes deeper, both within myself, with the people I'm working with, and also for the project at whole, sort of the whole project. I often think about filmmakers, for example, or film directors. All of them, they say that casting is the most important part of creating or making a film. Because if you don't do that, if you're not doing that thoroughly and really making sure that you get the right person for each part, you will have endless problems on the way trying to bring out whatever was there in your brain or in your thoughts or in your emotional feeling. And this is something I think a lot about when I'm building up an idea or gradually finding a way of surrounding the right people to support that project. In my mind, I think it's so important somehow to find a way to make and find this thread with the younger generation and to allow them to create something and find the strength in that, not needing to throw a lot of things in there just to make it more spicy. And when we talk about crossover art, I find it sometimes difficult to use that word because it also has negative sort of labels, because often we have crossover art which becomes too interested and too involved with putting too many things in there just to try to keep the attention of the person, to change all the time from one thing to the next, instead of finding the strength from the roots and build it up from there and gradually find the emotion of the piece and sort of almost like working with eggshells. So try not to break them all the time, to glue them together. Maybe to break them first and then to glue them together. Trust is so important. Maybe in the beginning, and it's often the case that I don't trust myself to do something because it will be too difficult, or I don't have the means to do it, and there are all these thoughts that tell me, don't do it. It's too something. It's too much work. It's too difficult. It's too expensive. You won't get the support to do it. And then, all right, you sort of try to embrace these thoughts, but at the same time not letting them pull you down. And then gradually to find the positive things about the project and why you should do it. And these questions are really, really important, not to just jump into and just to do something. I mean, some writers, they say, before you start writing a book, allow yourself to wait. It's again about waiting and starve yourself. Sort of keep on fasting, allow it to build up. It's almost like when you're boiling something and you have the pot. The pot is gradually simmering and it's getting stronger and hotter and it's boiling more and more. It's coming up to the surface. And when it's coming up to the surface and it wants to get out and just to go all over the place because you're getting so excited about it, you put the lid on and you keep the lid on and you allow it to really, like a volcano, to sort of try to get out, but you don't allow it to happen, not yet. And I think this is something I've learned gradually. It's about waiting for Godot, and also about trust. And then I'm also talking about trusting other people for your ideas, because the tendency is to protect whatever you've been working on for a long time, and you go into this route, and this route becomes so important, and then you allow somebody else to come in, and you need to trust that person, and whatever this person is ready to bring into the project, to listen to that also, and allow that to go into the brew. It's almost to brew whatever you want to create, and of course on the way you need to be ready and expect that you need to defend some of your ideas, and if somebody else has something to contribute that enhances that idea, not to just keep it out because your territory is sacred, something like that, you know. So it becomes exciting because there are more people coming in and they are bringing something, but at the same time everybody needs to be aware that it's the core, the root that you are protecting and allowing to grow, because too many ideas can spoil the brew. It becomes poisonous.